clean up a massive fuel spill in Delaware County. Challenges to contain it are causing environmental issues in other nearby areas. Chopper 3 is up over the scene in Brookhaven. Investigators say something went wrong at a gas station. The exact details are still unclear. Here's Howard Monroe.
Right now, we've got to figure out how it happened, make sure that it's not going to continue happening.
Many questions left to answer into what led to a massive fuel leak Saturday morning. Elected local, state, county, and federal officials toured the area surrounding Coburn Elementary School in Brookhaven Sunday morning. With them were first responders and emergency crews.
Right now, we're basically in the cleanup stage and monitoring stage to make sure it's safe for all the borough residents.
Officials say the leak began Friday night from the Gas and Go gas station on Edgemont Avenue. They say a tanker was filling the underground tank when it happened. Officials are trying to determine how much fuel spilled. One of them told Eyewitness News that as much as 5,000 gallons of fuel may have spilled. It's not clear if the spill happened below ground or at the top of the tank at ground level. Areas of the pavement around the tank area appear to be stained with fuel, and an inspector on site said the 10,000-gallon tank is full. The spill is also causing concerns to a nearby neighborhood off of Brookhaven Road. The spill got into a small creek that runs behind many homes. Officials say there's also wildlife concerns. Dozens of fish, frogs, and turtles were killed. There's also concerns for vegetation. The Delaware County District Attorney says criminal charges may be filed.
Whoever is responsible at the end of the investigation, we're going to see if they violated our laws, that we can bring them to justice.
Now, due to this fuel leak, the Pendelco School District says on its Facebook page that Coburn Elementary will be virtual on both Monday and Tuesday of this upcoming school week. In Brookhaven, Howard Monroe, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
The DEP tells us they've set up a protective boom system downstream, and they are keeping an eye on it for more contaminated water if it starts raining. For many of us, it's been a fairly pleasant Sunday from the shore to the suburbs, but we have chance for some storms overnight. Not what they want to hear in Brookhaven right now. Meteorologist Lauren Casey in to talk us through what to expect and timing. Hi, Lauren.
Hey, Joe. Yeah, nice end to our weekend. Again, the clouds did dominate city and surrounding suburbs, but we did see more in the way of sunshine earlier today. 77 degrees our current temperature down the shore. Another pleasant day for our Sunday, with the sunniest skies right now being reported in Millville and across portions of Delaware as well. But Storm Scan 3 showing us what is in some of our futures as we head into the overnight period. Thunderstorm activity, severe thunderstorm warnings, flash flood warnings in effect in association with this activity. Also, all of these pink boxes, severe thunderstorm watches. So we are going to see the potential for a few severe thunderstorms, especially to the far west Berks County, portions of the Lehigh Valley and Poconos under a marginal risk of severe weather. This is for storms that will move in overnight tonight. So mainly after midnight, scattered storms developing. Then as we head into our Monday, some hit or miss storms during the daytime hours. Most of us will stay mainly dry, but then we'll see another round of storms as we head into Monday night. Numerous in their coverage, and some could be severe. We'll time all of this activity out in your full Eyewitness forecast coming up in just a couple of minutes, Joe.
Lauren, thank you. It was a good day for celebrating in Royersford, where they held the first ever Pridezilla event. It is the largest all-day Pride event in the Delaware Valley. The outdoor event hosted by Soul Joel's Comedy Club kicked off today at noon and featured many local LGBTQ plus performers along with various vendors. The event is still underway and goes until 8 tonight. We're also observing Pride Month here at Eyewitness News. You can see all of our Pride Month stories on our website. Just head to cbsphilly.com/pride. Still ahead on Eyewitness News tonight.